What's up, y'all? Welcome to today. Whatever today is, welcome. Today I'm working on other languages. If you choose Swedish, this new translation by Farpub. Thank you, Farpub. There's a problem here. Look at this. You go to the controller menu. Everything is messed up. Super messed up. So, fixing that. Adding a certain character that's missing. That's what I'm working on. Here's the character that's missing right now. This A with a circle on top. So I'm going to add that to the font file. What's up, T? How you doing today, man? What you working on? So font.font. Start there. What's up, Zilton? Have you ever caught a good guy? No? Have you? So we'll duplicate these A's. We want the A with the little circle on top. Go uppercase. Select uppercase. Text. Uppercase. Yeah. Like a real superhero? Yeah. Nice, you're working on Swarmonian? How's it going? We need to look up some character codes for these Unicode characters. Voice of Grog, what's up, man? Have you ever tried disguise? Ooh, what a good idea, right? Catch him by surprise, and then catch him by the tail? It's the one here, just decimal 197. Is that right? What's this one? Decimal 193. Do I have those correct? This one's 193. Oh yeah, it looks like right. Okay, so this is gonna be 197. Big A with the circle on top. Makes me think of ice cream for some reason. Yes, you do. You do, man. I'm too much of a good guy. Not villainous enough. Yeah. So the little A with circle is 229. Confirming that one's 225. Yeah, 225, 229. Okay, they're both the same Y. We just want to go further on the X. Here's a lesson in trickery. Going down in history. I'm listening. Yeah? Uh-huh. 28, 144. You have to catch a superhero on the run? Oh yeah, you say it like a O? Like ah. Ah. Farpug, what's up, man? I'm working on the A with the circle on top. This is all thanks to Farpug. Farpug sent over the Swedish translation. So the mouth is a little more open than a normal O, like, oh. I'm not very good at this. I can already tell. So 144 minus 128 is gonna be 16, right? Yeah. So 16 plus It's gonna be 60, 160 here, 176 there. That's enough you can muster. Font fantastic. You're psyched for fonts? Horse. Horse. It's probably not even close. Horse. Or. Is that right? Or. So is this 170? What do we got here? This should be 160. Yeah, 160. 176. Good. Pretty close. Really? What's up, Rocket Bunny? Okay, then the X advance and the small X advance. Oh, those should be all the same as the other A's. Okay, good. We should have these two characters ready to use in this font. Now I need to put it into font shadowless. What else? I think I need to put it into not alien font, alien, but alien font needs like an entry for it, I think. Yeah, I do need it, and at least to put some entries to make the little font use some, or the alien font use the regular characters. So if we've If the regular or the alien font encounters one of these letters, these A's with the hat on top, it will still draw a regular A. So at least it'll be something. Well, an alien let regular A. And the last one is the small font. Well, you're traveling by bike? Nice. Is the full dialogue ready? What you mean by full dialogue? Like all the text in the game? The story's still not finished, so there's really a lot of there's a lot of dialogue that will still be created. Small font. Need one of these too. Oops. Okay, so the small font looks like these. This should be enough. I got that's all four of the game's fonts. They all now have this letter, the extra letter now. Oh, wait a minute. Did I just mess it all up? Don't tell me I lost it. Oh, good. Looks like they're also there. Okay. Because I gotta copy them back from the textures directory to the raw fonts directory. Oh yeah, you definitely. Yeah, wait as long as you need. There's still gonna be some story written. There'll be story written, definitely this month, next month. So there's still a ways yet till the game's all finished with its all of its strings. Okay, so now if I touch all these. Touch startup font and then rebuild. It should have copied all those font files. Just want to make sure that's working. Or just his sinking assets. Check the build script. Oh, it's a rsync A. Okay. Yeah, that should work. Rsync A updates anything that's newer. Okay, so now I need to go check if there's what string. It's SV, right? Yeah. So here's the Swedish. So we need one of these. Oh, here we go. Disconnected from Steam. It's got an A with a circle. Wrong. Fron. Is that close? Bort Club Fron Steam. It's probably hilarious to listen to this. I don't know what I'm saying. I don't know how to say it. Well, it's easy enough to find that string because all you gotta do is just be disconnected from Steam, which is... Yep, that was close, really? Not that bad, but funny. Hopefully. Alright, where achievements, here we go. Okay, so we're getting that problem with Yeah, it's not even drawing the character. Okay, well this is one of the other problems is it's like hold on, this is UTF-8, right? I'm pretty sure you sent it to me a UTF-8. Let's make sure it actually got copied over to my file that way. Joke translations? Why not? You just gotta swap a file. This is UTF-8, but it's UTF-8 bomb. I'm not sure what that means. Let's try just regular UTF-8. Oh, in the language select. Okay, there you go. Oh, that's byte order marker? You want to do lolcat? Why not? Do lolcat. So byte order marker, I wonder what regular... What's the difference between UTF-8 and byte order marker? Let's see if that actually affixed it with Cocos2DX. No, okay, so that didn't help. All right, no difference. I wonder if the game is complaining about missing characters. Yeah, it can't find letter definition for letter 305. Label text formatter. I'm gonna go ahead and run this with a different Xcode project with Cocos3DX. Right, indicates Indianness. I hear you. What's all this talk about villains today? Okay, so I want to find label text formatter, couldn't find. There it is. Can't find letter definition in font file for letter, blah, blah, blah. There's two places where it does this error. One is here in multi-line text wrap by word. And this one is multi-line text wrap by car. Well, either one of these. Set a breakpoint here and here and run it. We're chilling. Oh, man. So setting a breakpoint here, I can see what character is actually getting, what it's translating. Maybe it's not actually the right letter number. So like it was, I thought it was 193 or whatever from this. What is this, 197? But it might not actually be 197. When it gets here into Cocos 2DX for whatever reason. Thank you, Robbie Rutten. Well, it's up to you, Rocket Bunny. I'd recommend Visual Studio. Okay, so yeah, it's definitely that letter, or it looks like it is that letter. So what character is this? Yeah, it's the A. It's definitely the A. Okay. Oh, and this got translated as a 16-bit character. View this as something else. This is like, view this as decimal. Here we go. Decimal. View as decimal still shows me this. X? C string. It doesn't care. Bytes. I just want to see it as decimal, man. Binary? Come on. Jeez. Okay, how did it translate into UTF-16? That's weird. What's this UTF-16 nonsense? I thought I told you to be UTF-8. Okay, so it's got a U16 version of the string. Does it? C5 is 197? But so why didn't it find it then? That's weird. Cause I've got 197 in the font file. What font file is this? Letter definition. Cocoa City label. It's bitmap font. Here's our UTF-8 text, UTF-16 text. Why are you freaking out? See, the UTF-16 text looks all right, too. But it cannot find that character. Why can't it find the character? No Bitfoo. Bitfoo's not here today. I'm not sure where he is. Where? There it is. VM font file path. This is the font dot font. Okay, one more little verification here. What do we got here for assets, textures, font dot font? ID 197? Are they supposed to be in numerical order? That would be really weird. That may be. Hold on, let's try that. The bot is a bit too upset. Bopu's bit booed up. So this is the problem with working with someone else's video game engine. You know, I'm using an engine called Coco's 2DX here. I don't know exactly how they did everything, right? So little problems like this. How did they actually implement this with the UTF-16? How does the font file reader work? We'll find out. We're finding out right now. Together. Made raw fonts. Startup font. Okay, so we'll go to the regular font. My theory is that it doesn't know how to handle these when they're out of order. So let's jump to 197 and put it right at the beginning and see if it just... Oh no, it's gone. Son of a bitch bastard. What happened here? It lost them. What? Did it lose it from these two? Oh my god. Oh, it lost these two. I swear I copied these over like a minute ago. Oh, that's lame. Yeah, 197's gone all of a sudden. What about it might have still be in assets textures? It's gone. What? This sucks. Well, okay. Now I gotta redo it. Maybe there's something wrong with my script. Oh well. I'm having flashbacks. I remember doing this before. There's gotta be something wrong with my script. Okay, so let me show this file. How do I show in Finder, go to folder. Yeah, this is raw fonts. Okay. That's what I want to confirm. Okay, let's redo this. I'm sorry for your loss. He was a good font file while he lasted. We had many good times. But alas, our time together was short. I honor him with this rest in peace symbol. The symbol of my peace with his loss. 229 and 197. Okay, once again, this is one. Hold on. 160 and 176. Yeah. 160, 176. Okay, that should be good for that font. Now, alien font. Copy that. And this is 197 and 229. Font shadowless is exactly the same. And small font. It's gonna look somewhat like this. Only it's 197, 229. What's up, Psych Tooth? You don't envy me. I know, right? Who would? Yeah, I'm working with a game engine called Kogos 2DX, which this is kind of the way you do bitmap fonts. Well, not ever. No, there's tools out there which would that generate all this for you. But the problem is I'm using a lot of custom characters that all these tools don't know how to generate. So I have to do it all by hand. Wah, wah. Did I do these right? 16, 30, yeah, okay, this is right. Okay, so there. Now, the most important step is to back up these files I just created because I'm guaranteeing you they're gonna just disappear again in about 5 seconds. Okay, let me just do a little confirmation here. Did this actually... Is that actually there? Is that actually changed? Yeah, okay, we got the A's. Okay, let's close this. Okay, now... Man, rsync. What am I doing wrong with rsync right now? I thought the A option copied everything. Yeah, I thought A was supposed to only send the differences. Oh no, A is a lot of these options. Recursive, no, we don't want any, oh man. Maybe it's V or Z. Yeah, thanks, Vad. Yeah, custom font work, it does bring a nice touch, doesn't it? It's nice to draw your own fonts, right? Even though I have to draw lots of different A's and lots of different E's, lots of different I's and O's and U's. And look at all these other weird characters. How do you pronounce this one? Teak? What's this one here? It's like a, is it a W sound? Polish had lots of these. Polish has so many characters. At least you don't have to write it in assembly. There you go. Yeah, at least I don't have to do that, huh? Oh, it's a SZ sound? Zzz. Zzz. All I want to do is copy what's new. Update, there it is. Skip files that are newer on the receiver. It's dash U. No wonder this was all breaking. That moment when you realize that you've been an idiot. This is that moment for me right now. So my build script here. This was always copying. Was it? No, dash A does some other stuff, a bunch of things. All I wanted was dash U. Okay, so just to confirm, it's Vim, assets, textures, font, top font. And yes, it's missing the 197. Okay, and then I build. It should rsync U and update those files. Vim assets textures. Yeah, we got them now. We got the A with the circle. Woo! Yes. What's up, Kavarni? What's up, Ichni? Thank you, man. I definitely am. I'm working on some international fonts here. Okay, so this should hopefully now have the A with the circle on it. Yes, check it. We got an A with the circle. Okay, cool. All right, so the next thing is to start fixing whatever is the next problem we're having. This, the S, the steam right here, is all messed up. I don't know why. We'll start to figure it out. Yes, sweet. What? Yeah. That's pretty awesome. That looks a lot better, huh? With the A, with the circle. Probably other fonts are working now, too, I imagine. No, wait, no, nothing really changed with other fonts. Okay. All right, so yeah, next thing is to fix that, and it also happens here on this controller screen. Also looks like it's related to the letter S. Let's check out that controller line right there. Oh, and I can check that off my list now. Wait, why are you still running? That's weird. Huh. Check that one off the Trello list. A with the circle on top, no longer an open item. Okay, so the next thing, let's do this Swedish controller menu font all messed up. And then we'll change the language's courage symbol. Yeah, you do. You do, Psych2. That is kind of a downside, right? There's a lot of little things that I'd rather not have to do, but you know, I kind of like take joy in knowing that I'm solely responsible. Yeah, I know. If I had an intern, that would be sweet. They're like, intern, check it out. Fix these fonts. Fix these font files. And figure out why my script isn't working. Okay, so let's look at those files again. And we'll look at the strings. Right, yeah, it is. It's a great feeling, isn't it? I love it. I'm definitely a DIY kind of person. So that's why I really enjoy like doing every little thing. But sometimes, you know, it's like, sometimes it's not so awesome. What controller thing is that? Okay, let's look at English strings just for a moment. Oh, here it is. Menu add bindings. Set player one controls, set player two controls, and all that. Okay, so add bindings. Huh, it's a regular. Okay, let's see if it's this A with the two dots on top that's magically breaking it. Or it could be the lowercase letters after the S. Oops. Oh, that was it. Okay, so something's happening with the A with the two dots that it's like just messing up the rest of the font after it. So that shouldn't be too hard to figure out. It might just be the font file, probably. Let's see. So let's highlight these. What's the problem? Wait, no, not these. The A with the dots. Yeah. I know, console games, right? Especially in the case of Nintendo. Yeah. Writing console games is like sometimes the dark ages. Oh no. I'm not seeing any difference here. That was the A with two dots, right? Yeah. A dot dot. What if we put a little A dot dot? Or what if I just copy this A dot dot and overwrite that A dot dot? Is that somehow a different A? And we'll try this theory too, putting a little A dot dot on this one. Just to figure out what the hell is going on here. Oh, that could be. It could be, but like, I don't know. We might have to dive into Kogo City X's code a little bit some more. Figure out whether that is what's doing it. Okay, so neither of those things helped. But if I take away this big A, does it fix even the controller after it? Yeah, it does. Okay, so fix the entire line of text is all good. Okay, so let's go back to this other Songbringer project here. This project, basically, I'm building Kogo Studio X by hand. The other project, I have Kogo Studio X all pre-built and stuff. So I can't really step through Kogo Studio X's code with my project, but it's hella faster to on a daily basis. So I can just step through all Kogo Studio X's code here because this has all 900 source files or whatever all sitting as object files ready to go. So this is where it's processing that like a line of text. We'll set a breakpoint. Let's try the UTF-8 one first. UTF-8 index equals this A character. Or the UTF-8 or UTF-16. I'm not exactly sure how it does that. Oh, in fact, wait a minute. Let's copy these. Call this one C8. This one C16. Just so I've got these as debuggable variables. So if C8 equals that or C16. Set a breakpoint and run. Yeah, I think they had those extra lines had something else that's probably scrunched up too. Wait. Is it the C8 or the C16? Oh, it's this. Okay, so yeah. You can't represent. Wait a minute. Oh, it's trying to compare that. Oh. Wait, so how do you represent this? String? No, it doesn't like that. How about this? CA0? So like that. It's magic. I think it's working. So if you're not familiar with the WTF method of programming, I'm using it. I just write things, and if it doesn't work, I go, what the fuck? And just try something else. And that just worked. We'll see if it actually works. It might not have actually worked. Are the letters stored in a float vector? Maybe. Here we go. Awesome. Okay, so it's trying to render that A. Somewhere. Let's see what this is all. This is all like, what are these types anyways? This is just a const char star. Probably it's combining two characters together. Are the letters stored in a float vector? Why did I decide to do that? I didn't decide to store letters in a float vector. Are you looking at this? If you're looking at this code, this is Cocos 2DX. This is not my game engine. This is a game engine. It's freely available. Yeah, man. Triple pointers, quadruple pointers, quintuple pointers. You can have as many pointers to pointers as you want. Yeah, I'm in the game engine here right now. I'm looking at its code to try and figure out what the hell it's doing. Like I was mentioning earlier, if I had written this game engine, I would maybe have a clue what's going on, but now I just have to step through it and figure it out. Like, why is it messing up with this letter and not any other letter? So I think we've found it. This is index 5. In what font? What font is this? Or what string? Forstot. Fortsot. Is that close? Fortsot. What's Fortsot mean? Job security? You just realized why they decided to do that? Okay, let's see what happens when it actually goes to process this. See, it might actually be comparing it to like a one of these special characters and getting a true. Okay, so it's not considering it a new line. Or a carriage return or whatever that was. It gets the font definition. Let's see what the letter def is for this. Oh, okay. Oh, this is continue. Okay, this is what continue. Okay, what is this letter def? Because that it wasn't comparing it to any of those like special characters or whatever, so that's what I was hoping it might have been, like it maybe accidentally recognized it as that. This is the thing here: letter write equals letter position dot x plus letter def dot width, or and x advance. This is pretty important. Oh, and also additional kerning. All any of these things could be playing into it. So the letter definition, I guess this is X and Y. 64, 120, X advanced 9. All of these look okay. All right, so letter X. It's 49. Let's let this run. Let me take a screenshot. Oh, force dot works fine. So does installingner. Installingnar. But here's where we get the problem. And here's where I should take a screenshot so I can remember this. It's kind of missing, yeah. It's totally missing. Like I don't even know how what I'm saying but it's probably not even there, huh? Ah, well, this thing's getting a little more curious. Obviously, it has something to do with the interaction of letters. Well, not obviously, but maybe it has something to do with how these letters are interacting. Okay, I'm gonna set a breakpoint, but only if it gets the. If it finds this text. Because this is where it's breaking. Oh, interesting. So it's getting its length of the string based on the UTF-16 text, which makes sense. So it's definitely converting everything over to 16. And then, wait, so if UTF, if UTF-16 text dot find. Spilari. Spilar. Yeah. Not equal to string. Okay, we'll set this breakpoint now. No matching conversion for functional style cast from const char star a to standard U16 string. Man, I wish I knew how to do any of this. Well, let's figure out how it does it. UTF-8 to UTF-16. It's got a function it's using. Right? All right, this is just getting dirtier and dirtier. So let's take it from here. Oh wait, we need a like a UTF-16 or no, U16 string search. Okay, so my goal here is to set a breakpoint when it gets to the line that we know is broken, this one here, and step through it and figure out why it's broken. It starts getting broken. Let's see, one, two, three, 4 letters later, the S is shifted over a bit too much. And then the rest of the letters for a while are fine. And then there's some more just empty gap of a space. I think Yeah, the NES Classic. Right on. Yeah, man, I got my fingers crossed for you. Yeah, the entire text line. Well, each line is a separate line of text. These are separate labels. So that's a label, that's a label, that's a label. Each of them has a single array of UTF-8 and also a single array of UTF-16 characters. Both of those are represented in each of these labeled classes. Oh, wait a minute. I'm super curious if I take away the A from this line, if it will fix it, part of it. Let's see. That seems like a pretty good way to do it. Yeah, you wouldn't need to worry about text bunching up at all. But since I'm using this engine, I don't really want to mess too much with how they wrote their class because that could cause me an entire day of coding. You know, I'd be like, oh, now I broke that and I broke that and I broke that. I just want to fix whatever the hell is wrong with this particular line of code or particular section of code that's causing this to happen. So if I take away that A, we still have problems with text after this. Wait, I should replace it with another character so that it looks, the string is exactly the same length. Yeah. That it would. So yes, they are different. They're definitely different. If it has two of these kind of characters, then the string gets messed up in different ways, basically. This one has the P shifted, but this one has the S shifted. Oh, it's also interesting to note that It seems like it's related to the spacing. So when it creates an actual space, maybe that's what's going on that interacts weirdly with these other characters. Huh. I'm just trying to gather any kind of information I can here so I know what to pay attention for when I'm trying to debug their code. This is the kind of thing I wish I had an intern for. Debugging someone else's code. Yeah, so biggest news here is that it definitely works if there's no characters with 2 bytes or whatever. I wonder how it could be affecting letters like so much further on in the string, though. Oh, check this out. That is the pattern. Someone's DDoSing their login server. Bastards. Check this out. Every time there's a space, it's delaying the letter after it. So because this string here has the A with the 2 dots, when there's a space, it delays this next letter, and then here's a space, delays the next letter, the 1. And then there's another space after the 1 where it delays the next letter, the K. Oh, I think I see the pattern. All right, so, but that doesn't affect this one down here. Or does it? Wait a minute. If you look at just the A, see it does affect the next space. And then the next space, and then the next space. And then what about this A here? This A corrects this S, but then messes up the P. Anyways, okay, I'm just gonna focus on the first one here, and maybe that will fix the other one. Oh, you dropped. Damn. What's this record letter info function? Letters info dot line index UTF car valid position X, position Y. There's also placeholder info. Ooh, does it use placeholder? Is that what a space is? Aha! Oh, that's only if it doesn't find it. Let's set a breakpoint there just to see if it does ever do that. And we'll enable this other breakpoint. Oh, that's already enabled. Okay, I get it. So what's going on here is this function is basically just setting up the letter info for each one of the letters in this label. It's like setting its position. What else is it setting? It's line index, its actual character, whether it's valid, and its position Y and X. Hold on, this letters info class. What is a letter info? It's car 16, bool valid. But all of this, none of that is initialized. So what happens when it's a space? Let's find out exactly what happens when it's a space. That's obviously where something is going wrong here. Text length 17, line index next letter. Oh my God, check this out. Every time it's getting a letter definition, it's not necessarily. Yeah, it's not necessarily resetting it. Right, because all this could be invalid if it gets an invalid character or something. letter def width. So spaces are the one letter definition that doesn't have any width or whatever. So maybe there's some code in here that's like, ah, here's something. No. Letter position Y, record letter info. Letter write is one of the only ones I think that uses letter def.width. Letter write, what is that used for? Okay, that's just the rightmost point. Closer, getting closer. Pretty soon I'll have his bug fixed. Okay, the first character we've got. Letter position. Zero, zero. Ten, zero. This is zero, zero, ten, zero. There's a T, should be a T. Wait, what? is not the string I was thinking. What happened? Oh no. They're still being DDoSed. Okay, finally we have the right text. First letter. S. Is it X0, Y0? Character index and line index. Now we've got the A, we're at X0, Y0. T, X19, Y0. The other T, space. Forty-six-zero for the S. That appears reasonable. Fifty-six-zero. That was looking okay. Well, what if? What if there were no actions ever running on these? Okay, so that should be disabling all the actions that are running. It might be my own fault. Might be some thing going on with the... like running an action on a label. Still doing the scale Y thing. I don't think this has anything to do with it though. Something to do with how the labels are getting set up. That's where it gets its position for each child sprite. Okay, yeah. There's no actions at all running on these labels. There's still nothing. Okay, so it's not that. Just wanted to verify that. Okay, so instead of doing that, and stepping through each step of all that, I'm gonna go and loop over all the letter info, letters info vector. All right, first letter. Three, 100 for the space, 109, 115, 124. This is fine. I've learned anything so far, it's that this function is okay. What the hell? Yeah, all these position X's and position Y's are totally okay. Here's something. What if I don't try and do change spacing? Please work. I know. That's the problem. Yeah, so it wasn't Cocos, it was my own thing, or it was the way my own thing interacts with Cocos. So I've got this function that's supposed to squeeze a line of text and make it smaller, right? They'll change the letter spacing. And that's, in this particular case, this line of text down here, all these lines of text are pretty long. And so I'm trying to add like -1 pixel per letter, and something's gone wrong in my own function. It could be the way my function's interacting with Cocos though. Oh, this is great. All right, well, at least we got this so far, so. Oh, and I'm using const cars as well. Yeah, it did. It took them years to get rid of a lot of those Objective-C conventions. Still haven't. Okay, so I'm gonna go re-enable this change spacing function and just step through the string. Oh my God, it's so good to be back in my own code base. What's wrong here? Why is it doing this? So we start with index one. We're skipping the first letter. First character is weird. Not gonna lie. It's a UTF-8 character, probably. Can we view this as binary, please? Yay! It's a UTF-8 character. Because the last bit set. I watched my number file video on that one. Okay, so the delta, what's that? Oh, the delta could get totally messed up if a character is offline or whatever. Oh, this makes sense. Delta equals the character is a new line. Any UTF-8 character would not match a new line. It shouldn't. Oh, this totally makes, it's starting to make sense, because I'm treating this as a completely as a UTF-8 string, or a, basically just regular ASCII characters. That's probably what's going on here. So the delta is now 2. The character is okay. The sprite is okay. So the X position was 18. And the delta is now 2. Yeah, right? Yeah. Oh, am I calling getLetter with the wrong index? Yeah, that's possible, Farpoke. It totally is. We'll see. I know, this is the troubleshooting that'll get you right here, too. These little things. See? I never really studied how UTF-16 strings work. I always ignored them. So this is starting to bite me in the ass right now, but I'll get this fixed. Okay, so the spacing delta I think should only be... The delta should start at 0. Change that in a second. Next time I compile, that should start at 0. So the first letter should only move back by 1 pixel. This is going to move it back by 2 pixels. So X is 16 now, and it goes sprite set position X to 16. Why is it changing the camera mask? Oh. Oh my god. Here's something I should really check before I even do any of this. If I don't even set the position X, if all I did was get the sprite and set the camera mask, let's see if it still breaks. Yeah, Turticus, yes, you're right. Oh, well, what am I? I'm talking like I know what I'm talking about, but I don't. Don't trust me. Don't trust the man behind the curtain. Oh, it worked, huh? Okay, so it is, it's definitely my own fault. It's just my fault from changing the position. It doesn't have anything to do with getting the sprite or setting the sprite's camera mask. Yeah, so this is a, there's, the way the label works is the label has a representation of the string as UTF-8. And it also has a representation as UTF-16. I'm looping over the 8 portion. So it's just something with how mine handles the 8. See that? Now it's broken. It's just this spacing delta. So let's step through it one more time. Yeah, it wasn't crazy bad. I didn't have to go into their code or fix their stuff. And it wasn't even their fault. It was my own fault. Okay, so first letter. Well, this is the second letter in the string, which is the A. So X started as 18, X becomes, should be 17 now, cool. See, what's probably going wrong is the delta, because the delta changes per iteration of the string. And if there's two characters, which this next character, oh, wait a minute, this first character that we're dealing with is gonna be two strings. Or two. You probably just want to see if it has the UTF-8 bit and just skip that character. This first character right here, C, has the UTF-8 bit, so I should probably just skip this character. See what happens with the next character. Oh, wait, what was the sprite? Damn. Hopefully it still has the sprite. Yeah, it's 1121B8E00. Now this character is also UTF-8 character. Okay, so I wouldn't want to skip every character. Or every UTF-8 character. Mm-mm. Is it time?
It's almost time to go. We probably have like 10 minutes.
Oh, okay. All right, 10 minutes. Hopefully I can get this bug fixed. So X is 17. So it is a different sprite. Asking the label for get string length and entering from zero. Oh, yeah. That's a good idea. Yeah, start there. Before I forget, I'm going to go back to this text formatter and just undo everything I've done. It's string length. I think it's a great idea because I think string length uses the UTF-16 string. Yeah, it does. The UTF-16 string's length. Which is probably genius, Farpoke. Genius. It's probably what I should have done the whole time, huh? Just loop over length. And then that's just going to get, I should get the right letters that way. Let's see what, hopefully this just works. If this works, it's all credit to Farpoke. Oh, still something wrong. Okay, it's probably just something wrong with the math still. Probably, it's so close. It's so close to being fixed. At least the indexing should be right now. Because when it calls get letter, that's pretty important to call with the right index. I'm not even going to step anymore. What I want to do is faster. So I'm going to use a log statement and just show what the X was and what the X becomes. And only do this. So dirty. There. So that'll just show, you know, each letter, what the X position was, what the X position becomes. Oh, and I should be tracking the delta too. Oh, did I forget to even go into that? Whoops. Anyways, delta. Is it really dirty if it works and it's not great bugs? Good point, bud. I'm gonna throw away all this code anyways. Once I know what fixes it, I'll be like, oh, there we go. This will literally be like a one line change that took like 2 hours to fix. Okay, there it is. X goes 18 to 17, 27 to 25, 36 to 33, then 0 to negative 4. That looks wrong. That might work. That might help. I think this is the problem right here. Once it gets to a space character, is that time?
We got 5 minutes.
5 minutes? Mm-hmm. 5 minutes, or we gotta go now?
We got 5 minutes until you finish, and then we gotta go.
All right. So close. Oh, and see, then here the delta gets even bigger by one more index. Oh, and these indexes are wrong. This is actually letter index I plus one. So string.begin to iterate, does that actually... Hold on. UTF-8 string iterator. Does that plus plus? Does it? Let me just do. If this is a UTF-8 character, what is that? How do I represent that? Is that 127? Okay, if it has 128, or what's that as hex? 80, duh. So if that's a UTF-8 character, let's just increase the index by one. And let's use the labels string length. Or I mean, not the label string length, but the actual string size. And we can go int letter equals 0 or letter equals 1. So we go letter equals 0 here, and then letter plus plus. So I represents the character index and letter indicates the actual label letter. Oops, the letter. Oh man, this is just so dirty. I'm all rushed. I've got to get going here soon. So it's probably the last time I get to run it. So let's hope it works now. If it doesn't work now, I will definitely get this fixed after dinner. But we got to go out to dinner. We got a friend in town. We're going to go see our friend. So, come on. Let's cross your fingers. Oh! It works. All right. There. So, all I did was I just iterated over the C string differently than, or the UTF-8 string versus this UTF-16 string. So, the letter index... The letter variable is the index into the actual UTF-16. Or no, this is the letter index into the, yeah, what would be the UTF-8-16 string. And then the I is the letter index into the C string. All right. So there you go. That whole, basically, all that time, it was my own code. It was my own fault. And all I was doing wrong was just iterating over a label the wrong way. So because I didn't take into account that some UTF-8 characters are 2 bytes. All right, guys. So thanks a lot for watching, and I'll be back tomorrow doing something else. And appreciate all y'all. Thanks, Farpoke. Thanks for submitting the Swedish translation. Glad it's going to be working and looking a lot better now, too. So, yeah, there's probably still something wrong, but I'll check into it. So, cheers, everybody. Have a good night.